Hello everybody and welcome to another game entirely. This is OpenTTD or Open Traffic Tycoon Deluxe. The original Traffic Tycoon Deluxe is a game released in 1994. It's 22 years old now, I think. At some point the code passed into the public domain and people modified it to work on modern machines and to handle mods really quickly. And smoothly. It's now an amazing game with a great modding scene, and 22 years in, it's still a lot of fun. So let's jump into the game. I generated a map for us already with a lot of fun stuff to explore. So this is the map we will be playing on. It's a randomly generated map. It has towns, it has industry, and just some general water. I'm playing with only one mod activated, which is the fictitious Dutch town name mod. So it has names that, well, in theory could be found in the Netherlands. So let's just start. Over here we have a lot of options. I'll start by showing off the company screen. This is our company. At this point it's company one and it's unnamed. So let's change the company name. It's going to be B Transport Incorporated. Bam. We're also going to change our color scheme to, I think I want light blue, yes. And the new face for the manager, let's just, I like this guy, let's go with him. Now the next thing we'll take a look at is the finance screen. So naturally the goal of this game is to make money. We start with a bank loan of 400,000 guilders. And we can loan up to 1.2 million. Now at the moment we're not making any money because we have no lines in place yet. We still have to build everything. Let's take a look around the world. It's often a wise idea to start with a simple coal to mine to energy plant. Every industry has a display, has a chain of industry. So a coal mine produces coal and a power station, well, accepts coal and turns it into power. But power is just kind of an invisible thing not seen in the world. So if we were to create, for example, a railroad between this coal mine and this power station, we would be making a profit from transporting the coal. Although these are really close together, I'd rather have two that are a little bit further apart. These are also very close. I like to start with a little bit of a distance, especially if there is flat terrain. Let's see. Ooh, there are two coal plants over here. We could get these two connected. It would be a really nice first line and would give us a little bit of a base income. So let's select railway construction because that's the main way we will be transporting bulk goods. Now we first have to build a railway station. Let's get this orientation. The white outline on the ground is where the station will be, and the blue outline is its coverage. So the blue outline needs to be at least in one square of the industry, otherwise we won't be able to transport the goods that that industry supplies. So let's put it in, yeah, about over here. That leaves us, oh, we can build well past. Let's unpause the game first of all and put in the station. Pause again. we will give it an appropriate name. All mine. It's just easier for me, so I can actually see what the station supplied instead of having to click on it. Now let's start our rail construction. We will be making use of a system I developed over playing this game for a couple of years. We will use a two-way rail system, which basically means that there will be two railways next to each other on every piece of track. But let's just first, I'll explain this later. Make this a little bit longer, like so. And let's put in some signals on this piece of track. We'll be using the one-way signals and putting them up in front. Oh, and I think we also need them behind the station. Well, let's actually see. Let's just do it like this. And then this will be our main two tracks. And we'll connect the station up to this. So this is the outgoing track. So it needs to be connected here and connected over here. Now this is the incoming track. So it needs a connection here. And it also needs a connection there. Right, so now we fix that up. We need to turn the corner over here. And let's... Ah, that's our first obstacle in the way. We'll have to build a bridge over this river. Let's just take the most expensive one. And this will actually bump into the power station. So I'll just connect it up till here and then have some station infrastructure over there. But first let's put in a train depot. Otherwise we can't actually service and buy any trains. Yeah, this will be fine. Let's start to build our station over here. Yes, I like this orientation. Let's rename it to a power plant station. Put in one track on each side and then let it veer off towards... Well, let's just connect it up like this for now. In the future, we'll actually have a different connection over here because we actually want like a kind of road system where track doesn't immediately connect up to any stations, but just kind of goes around and the trains have to, like over here, leave the main track to go to the stations. That way we'll get a much better flow of traffic. Let's put in the necessary lights. Let's see. Now there are visibility options which help you, transparency options over here, which help you look at bus stations, so I see that I've put these signals in the wrong way. They're right now, so I'll make them come back. Now they're actually, I always have this one on. There are actually a lot of trees on the map, but they hinder your view quite spectacularly, so I always have them turned off. They're still there, but you just can't see them. Now let's put in some canvas. Oh, a canvas signals will pass. Let's put in some signals around the track. This helps the trains with path finding. And let's build this intersection while we're at it. Oh, this is actually that far apart, which is a bummer. Actually delete this one. Think, yes, that works. And let's put in a signal over here, one over here, and then just till the end. Alright, this should work. So let's buy our first train. We'll buy a new vehicle. There's only one bridge, so I think this train will do. This is a less powerful engine than the most expensive one, but it's a lot cheaper. So we'll get this train engine, and we need coal trucks. Yes, coal trucks over here. Our stations are 4 long, so we need we can have 8 total trains. Now we have bought a train, but we still need to give him some orders. So we'll make him go to the coal mine. We'll make him load, fully load any cargo, but we don't actually need to, just fully load any cargo. It doesn't need to unload anything. And then we make it go to the power plant, far end, and unload everything and leave empty. So now we can press on this bar and it will start, and it's heading for Drievoorde coal mine. Let's just speed up time a little bit till it arrives. All right, the signals are working correctly for now. Now it's waiting over here, and it will have to load fully. So this coal mine produces coal over time, and it will slowly load the train. It will actually take a few months, I think, before it's actually full the first time around. But the trip also takes time, and what will happen is while it's away, the station will still accrue coal, and once it's back, it can fully load immediately and just be on its way. So only the first time it needs to wait in the station like that. This game is basically a model train set with the added goal of making money. But I mean, the main goal is just building rails and trains and making everything look pretty. It's not a very hard game to make money in, so you just want to build nice infrastructure, I guess. Let's speed up time a little bit till it arrives. So it's entering the station over here, and it will start to unload its coal, and we will get paid. Interesting to see how much we will make. We will get 42,000 guilders. That's not bad. So if we take a look at our finances now, we have spent 113,000 on construction, 90,000 on vehicles, and it has cost 2,000 to run. But we've also made 42,000 from this train. So that's not bad. If we don't count the construction, we would be actually making quite a bit of profit. So the train is already on its way back. I'll just speed over this piece of track. And now there's actually 230 tons of coal waiting over here. so it will quickly just load it in. It doesn't have to wait for the coal mine to produce the coal. And it will leave the station almost empty. So, our first line is done and we actually have some money coming in. I thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoy this game. It's a little bit different from the normal Victoria 2, but I'm pretty excited to be playing this again. I'll be just connecting a lot of this map up and see where we'll leave it off. Thank you all for watching. I'll see you all next time.